Hey, we're back. I changed the lights to red for this one. It kind of makes it look like I'm in hell, which is kind of fitting because we're in quarantine and being home on quarantine, not being able to leave and see my friends, is a personal hell for me.
Coming back, I miss your strong embrace. I want to believe we have a chance to let our hearts escape. I need you here with me, you see it on my face. I know that when our heart beats one, our troubles will be overcome. When you're coming back, I miss your strong embrace. I want to believe we have a chance to let our hearts escape. I need you here with me, you see it on my face. And know that when our heart beats one, troubles will be overcome, overcome, overcome. Embrace, I miss your strong embrace. I want to believe we have a chance to let our hearts escape.
Hello everybody, Noel here, and I decided to try something new during this quarantine time. So I'm going to do this thing called Quarantine Diaries, where basically I'm going to be recording myself doing a video every now and then about how life has been with this, with the COVID-19 situation. First off, I hope everyone is able to make the best of their situation despite what's going on outside. I hope you and your families are safe. And yeah, that's the first part. Secondly, it's been pretty tough dealing with this quarantine from a first-hand experience. Today actually marks 3 weeks since I've been outside. I came home from school the 17th of March, and today is April 7th.
This video, or this diary, quarantine diaries, I talked about this. Again, we're going to talk about it again. At first, I was like, no one cares. But I was like, I do. So this is what we're going to talk about.
It is now only 7:26 a.m. And I've been awake since yesterday of around 4:30 p.m. Going through the coronavirus and everything, I tend to, well, whenever I'm home, I tend to mess up my sleeping schedule pretty badly. Running out of time, running out of time, running out of time.
This is my quarantine. I don't do much. I wear the same sweatpants. I feel like my mind is idling. There's not much to do. Sit around, think. I want to go outside. 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 I want to go. If I'm inside, let me at least try to get some sun. There you go. That's better. If I think hard enough, it's almost like I'm outside. Not really, but I'll take it.
Walking around my neighborhood and seeing people at home with their families is something that's much more common now than before this entire pandemic. And it leaves me happy to see that people are trying to stay safe. Yet, I'm still stuck focusing on issues that shouldn't matter at the moment. Tonight, I'm probably going to go back to my computer and edit this video together. And I'll struggle with the choice of song that I'll use for this little diary. I'll struggle with how I look in the camera. But that's the thing. There's no single concept, idea, art, or even song that defines who we are. Truth is, I don't really know how to define myself, how I feel, and why I act the way I do. But being forced to stay in the box that I've always tried to stay in has left me feeling more lonely than before. I can't help but repeat my... Regardless, I'll fight my own fight and attempt to grow in the midst of this. I just don't know how I'm going to endure it all. But to all that are listening, just know that I will. That's all I can do. Now, some may listen to my narration and be confused by my purpose in it. But I just believe it's easier for all of us if we can express ourselves through our art, whether it be in someone's face or subtle. I'm hoping to band together as many people as I can during this time. Anybody that shares my sentiments can hopefully feel relieved that others feel the same, or at least feel relieved that they understand exactly what they feel through my words. We can get through it together.
Sorrows like sea billows roll.
We have had a couple scares, like, you know, some family members not feeling too well, but fortunately ended up not being serious. So it ended up just being like something as simple as a common cold. And it didn't get to the point in which we needed medical assistance. In my neighborhood, it's been pretty quiet. There haven't really been a lot of people around, just because it's a very densely populated area, so a lot of people have been staying home. I actually live half a mile from a hospital, so lately, every time it's around 7 o'clock, I would say, that people are leaving or going in, there are always people at their windows just applauding them for the work that they're doing. And it's good that they're being appreciated, they're being recognized for the work that they're doing right now, because they have to work in the hospitals nonstop for the sake of others.
Broke it off, built me up, when looking you got me sleeping. Got different clothes, I changed my ways, but still I don't feel that different. You got me reminiscing. The weight of your touch when your fingers dance across my shoulder. The change in your voice when you talked about us getting old. Yeah, I was hoping it'd be different when I saw you, but it feels the same, never changed. I was certain I flushed you on my system, but you printed it, my DNA. My heart's pushed into a corner, my brain is out of order. It's why you mess with the talks every time you look at me that way. Nothing's changed. No time crossed my mind, second that I get near you.
I've been isolated for 2 weeks and now I have a chance to spend time with them. Everyone needs attention, especially kids. Being in a quarantine with family, they are more than happy. We do follow the basic rules even if we walk around the house. We try to wear a mask and use gloves, but I want to shift the colors of the situation from something dark to something light for them. I explained them everything and they understood. They are protecting themselves and try to help other people too. We all should do this. Quarantine is just the time which we need to use for our family. So show them your love and stay home.
The games you played were never fun. You'd say you'd stay, but then you'd run. Giving you what you're begging for, giving you what you say I need. I don't want any settled scores, I just want you to set me free. Giving you what you're begging for, giving you what you say I need. Say I need. I'm not afraid anymore. What makes you sure you're all I need? Forget about it. When you walk out the door and leave me torn, you're teaching me to live without a word. I'm so bored. I'm so bored. So bored.
Are be going crazy within the next day or so.
It's like a different world.
I can't wait for this all to be over.
1500 of being in the house, and I miss my friends, my girlfriend.
It's hard to find the motivation to wake up, exercise, do your homework, all the things you would have done at home on a normal day. It's hard knowing that you're forced to stay inside.
Being home during this time, granted, like, everything is going kind of crazy in the world. It kind of gives me the time to appreciate my family.
So this is me reporting live from my porch. Quarantine is literally the worst thing I've ever experienced. I have papers to write, I have things to do, and I just can't find the motivation to do them.
I mean, I miss my friends. I miss being able to go out. I miss my stuff that's in my dorm room still, you know. But I just hope everything gets back to normal soon.
So this is second time when I'm going outside. The whole street looks like without misty and snowstorm. But there's still a lot of snow on the roads, as you can see. Now is 12 p.m. No power yet. It's all day without light. Today was extremely strange and disaster day. All day I was at home, as usual, because all people now at home under quarantine. It is a lot of snow. It happened in one day. All snow that you watched fall in one night. So now I'm going to bed. Thank you for watching this video. Stay safe. Bye.
What did I do today? Today I literally did nothing. I went to the supermarket twice, which is amazing because I got to go outside. And it's actually really scary out there because, like, there's like no one, and like the people that you do see have like masks and like headgear and like gloves on. For the next one, I think I'll record that. Like, next time we go to the supermarket, I'll have one, like a recording of like walking over there, I guess.
She even had the gate down. Thank you.
Quarantine has been a bus. I'm bored. I've been working out though. Oh, can I show them my dance moves?
Yep. Okay.
Yes, thank you.
Shoes?
Bottom.
Okay.
Oh, well. There you go. You may enter.
Currently in Belize, about 3,000 miles away from all my friends. This is day 30, I think, of quarantine. I've been outside about once. I really, really, really miss my friends. I miss human interaction. I have lived the same day 30 times.
Being quarantined and stuck at home is so annoying. It's like a pause in your life and you didn't expect it at all. Professors are out here giving 10 times as much homework because you're at home and they think you have time to do work, which that is not the case.
Being in quarantine has been pretty hard. I'm not on campus, so I can't hang out with my friends or play video games at night. It's a lot harder to get up for class when you don't actually have to get up for class. It's just rough.
Okay.
My mind.
personally, what have I been up to? I haven't really been up to anything, honestly. All I've really been doing is, I've just been playing video games, doing, keeping up with my classwork, sleeping. It just sucks for me because as an athlete, I can't really practice, work on my sport outside. Because baseball is a very outdoor sport. So, in fact, my college season actually ended up getting canceled. And my summer ball season is right now in the air because we're still not sure, depending on how this situation progresses, whether or not we end up having a season. And yeah, that's pretty much been it. And I'll probably do another one of these sometime soon. Alright, Noel out. Alright, so time for segment number 2 of Quarantine Diaries. Once again, I hope everyone is doing well during this situation. And I hope, and my prayers are with those who have been affected with it, as well as those who are trying to stay safe during the situation. And I hope God continues to protect you guys. Now, for me over here in New York City, tomorrow will be 1 month since I returned home from college. And I've been pretty much inside for the most part.
So today, when I got up and looked into my window, I watched that all window is white. It is snow during April. My mom is growing some flowers for summer, and look into this window. Summer is not close, I think. Let's go outside and have a look how's life going in Kazakhstan in quarantine days. So we're going outside. Oh, it's a lot of snow there. It's very difficult to ride. Oof. I can't go very far from home because I will not find it. So that's it. Oh.
Every day around 7 o'clock-ish, I always hear people outside applauding the healthcare workers, and once again, I do like to thank them for all the effort that they're doing, that they're putting forward, all the countless hours working with patients, with and all the risks that they're taking. Now, what have I been up to? So I started a podcast, which I do every Wednesday night on my Instagram.
And basically all I'm doing is I just discuss rap music. I discuss, you know, both past and present, as well as what could possibly happen in the future.
Okay, I'm bored in a house and I'm in a house, boy. Boy. Bored in a house and I'm in a house, boy. Boy. Bored in a in a house, bored and I'm bored in a house, boy. Bored in a house, bored in a house, boy. Boy. Bored in a house, bored in a house, boy. Boy. I'm bored in a in a house.
Pew, pew, pew. Pew, pew, pew. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a chopper. It's a chopper. Hold up. Wait a minute. It's a 22.
Hey guys, good morning. I planned of taking you guys a walk through my farm. So the plants which you see here is coconut trees. We planted lots and lots of coconut trees. And you see the huts. The huts are under renovation. And that's where I live. So around me there are no buildings, huge buildings. They are just an empty spaces of land. That there is no internet connection. Plus, you cannot. Oh yeah, you can see chickens over there. So we just have few chickens, and my farm is quite big, so it's quite tough to go around and complicate everything around there. So I'll show you a gist of it. See, it's you can just see it's completely greeny over here, where a kind of less pollution due to the pandemic situations like this. I'm just waiting for it to grow. Really, like it takes about 2 years it to be fully grown. So. My farm consists of lots of plants and lots of vegetables. Where we will be producing all these stuffs and we will be giving it to the others who are in need of it. So the whole farm is under renovation. So you could find lots of stuff like wood down and everything like that.
Out there, man, you know, they got that one good girl, dog, that's always been there, man, like,
so lonely,
and one day she can't take it no more and decide to leave.
Yeah, I woke up in the middle of the night, wondering why she had to go and take that flight. Could have sworn I was dreaming, for her I was fiending, so I had to take a little ride. Backtracking on these few years, trying to figure out what I do to make it go bad. Cause ever since my girl left me, my whole life came crashing and I'm so, so lonely, Mr. Lonely, I have nobody, on my own girl, so lonely, Mr. Lonely, I have nobody, on my own girl, can't believe I had a girl like you when I just let you walk. Out of my life. After all I put you through, you still stuck around and stayed by my side. What really hurt me is I broke your heart, baby. You were a good girl and I had no right. I really wanna make things right, cause without you in my life, girl, I'm so, so lonely. Mr. Lonely, I have nobody.
Mr. Long.
Hi everyone. Let's see what's going on outside today. It's pretty late and the city is almost empty. These roads are usually full as people have country houses in this location. As you can see, there is no one, so I guess it's time to sing. Everyone needs to do grocery, so let's choose the store somewhere in the quiet location. Time to travel back. Stay home and be safe.
So, I'm playing this game recently called Animal Crossing New Horizons. And it's a game where you basically set up your own village with all these animal characters. And they're all really cute. And they all have their own different personalities and their own little quirks and whatnot. And you basically have an island with them. And you are the manager for them. So you manage, like, how the terrain is going to look, where the houses are going to be, where the shops are going to be, and whatnot. So
I was saying the creep people back on some super creepy aren't they?
Lille ankel.
Men prøv at overveje. Jeg fik dig at vide, inden jeg tog til Østrig.
Baby, won't you meet me by the beam? Too early, maybe later, you could show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit Windy City, she blowing me kisses. No, 30 degrees, way too cold, so hold me tight. Will I see you at the show tonight? Will I see you at the show tonight?
Truck to the plane, to the truck, truck to the hotel lobby. Me, I go through underground garages, presidential suite on deposit. Elevator up to the room, shower up and then we hit the club. Touchdown, gotta see what's up. Area code in my phone, what numbers do I still have? Who do I know from the past? Hit one, she say she got a man. Hit another one, it goes green. Must have changed foes on the team. Remember when you let me in between? That was 2017, all good.
My baseball training, I've managed to do some of it inside, you know, things such as throwing, conditioning, stuff like that. I've been able to do it without having to leave my house, or sometimes with the conditioning at least, not leave my apartment building. Since I live all the way on the top floor, I'm able to use running up and down the stairs as an advantage to help me stay in shape. And there really hasn't been much going on with my quarantine. I'll check back in with you guys again next week. Until then, easy money out.
face of the sun. Waiting for these things to come. We smile and hide, watching the good things passing by. Pretend to feel it fine.
Hi guys, today will be a little bit lyric video, because in it I will show how we celebrate May 9th. In America this is May 8th, I think, the end of the Second World War. And so now I am in Victory Park, it is calling like that in honor of the victory. I walk past statues with heroes who were at the battlefield, who worked tirelessly in the rear. Next is Eternal Flame and a huge wall with the names of people who died in the war. Also a large statue in honor of the soldiers of the Red Army, it is Soviet Army. In general, the Eternal Flame is burning from May 9 to maybe May 7th or 8th, and then we light it again at the ceremony on May 9th in the morning. We don't have this ceremony in this year, and unfortunately we don't have parade in this year. I don't know if you have something like that. If you have, send me feedback, please. Now I'm going to lay off flowers. And it's true, all my friends, they have grandfathers or great-grandfathers who fought in this war. So some of them died and some of them come back. Further, I would like to show how the apple trees blossom. And it is very beautiful.
We're getting ready. for our daily walk. And such a beautiful day.
Hey guys, my name is Dharmendra Ravi. I thought of doing a special video, like interviewing my friends so that we could get some ideas or thoughts regarding quarantine. So I interviewed my friend. So I'll be sharing a video. Watch it and stay happy. Thank you so much.
Hey guys, my name is Abhishek and I'm from Mumbai. So I'd like to share some views on how my quarantine is going nowadays. Like how it's been in my past and how it's been now. So since the quarantine has been started, there are also advantage and disadvantage of the quarantine. And advantage comes like we get relief from the college days, we get relief from studies, we get a break to relax, and then we get to break, and we also get time to spend with our families and friends in our home, like who is always in work, who is running always 24 hours into 7, and they are spending time with us. And disadvantages are like there are also some people who migrate from one place to another place to do their works, and because of this lockdown situations, there has been no transportations and no vehicles been running nowadays. So it is being like they can't go back to their home. This is also one of the problem. And my problem was this. I was staying in Coimbatore, I was studying in Coimbatore, and now because of the lockdown, no flights, no trains, and nothing is available. So it is like I can't go to my home, and I can't I can't see my family, I can't spend time anywhere. And since the food and the restaurant are being closed, so people like me who are staying in hostels, since the hostel mess are also being closed, so people like me, students like me who have been trapped in this lockdown have to go through this situation where we don't even get foods and transportations. So these are some disadvantages in quarantine. And if you go to advantages, it is like we get some rest from 24/7 work. And that's my view on this. Thank you guys.
Get time to realize it's right before my eyes.
can take it if it's what I want to do. I am leaving, and this is starting to feel like it's right before my eyes, and I can taste it. It's my sweet beginning. And I can tell just what you want. You don't want to be alone. You don't want to be alone. And I can't say it's what you know, but you know it the whole time. Yeah, you know it.
Hello guys, this is my diary number 3, and for today my dad had an idea. So he wanted to do some kind of food baskets and go to real places where old people don't have access to buy food or any kind of help because of their age and they can't get out of home. So we went to the marketplace and we got rice, black beans, cleaning soap, oil, cookies, pasta, and some other necessary things. Now that bags are done, we just gotta wait until it's Friday to drop them to the real places.
Life's not fair, is it, my little friend? While some are born to feast, others spend their lives in the dark. Begging for scraps. Everything you see exist together in a delicate balance. While others search for what they can take, a true king searches for what he can give. Run away, Simba, and never return.
And in my 18 years of living, I've never experienced something at this level in which people have to stay inside for so long. But I do hope that everyone is making the best of it. And yeah, that's pretty much it. And this concludes this quarantine diary.
Close your eyes. I'm still beside you. Goodbyes needed today.
something grows. Stay with me. Stay.